I've got great news. Well, for somebody great, for somebody not so great, because, well, Parker Porter is out. Arlovski is going to step in to face Chase Sherman at UFC Vegas 24. Andrei Arlovski, you know him as the former UFC heavyweight champion, 6'4", 77 inches is his reach. 30 wins, 20 losses, 2 no contests. Well, his last two matches, he had ups and downs. Got to say, he had losses to Jairzinho Rozenstruik, rear naked choke loss to Tom Aspinall, and decision wins over Filip Linz, Tanner Bowser. I mean, his stamina is not bad at all, man. I mean, Andrei Arlovski's stamina is not bad at all, and he is a good puncher. Earlier, he was a very good ground and pound fighter, but right now, I don't know, this older version of Andrei Arlovski is more of a stand-up striker, but I'm impressed with the way Andrei Arlovski still fights, and the Pitbull, 42 years old, and he is still one of the best fighters in the game. ATT fighter, international master of sambo. Actually, he is good in submission defense, as well as you can see from his score. Only two losses via submission. His ground game is pretty much good, but right now it's not that ground game that used to be. Chase Sherman, purple belt in kickboxing under Duke Rufus, blue belt in BJJ, riding a score of 15-6. Got to say that Chase Sherman is riding on an excellent winning streak, 4 wins in a row over Frank Tate, Jeremy Mayer, Sean Jackson, and Isaac Villanueva, Ricky Villanueva. In his first UFC run, he lost to Justin Ledev, Walt Harris, Shamil Abdurakhimov, Justin Willis, Augusto Sakai, but defeated Rashad Coulter and Damian Grabowski. As much as I know, Chase Sherman didn't go well in his first UFC run. At bare knuckle, he was pretty solid. Draw against Sam Shoemaker. He outworked Arnold Adams and lost to Joey Beltran. He was the BKFC heavyweight champion. So I got to say that Chase Sherman is a master striker. And he is a master striker. He is better striker than Andrei Arlovski. But if the fight gets dragged to the ground, we could see a submission game. And the submission domination of Andrei Arlovski. But Chase Sherman's takedown defense is like so-so. It's not the best in the world, but it's not poor. And the point is, the guy has never lost via submission, which worries me even more, you know. It worries me even more because look at the names he fought, and he has never lost via submission. So not gonna be an easy match for Andrei Arlovski. I know that Andrei Arlovski, I mean, right now he is a gatekeeper, but he's still fighting very well. He battles constantly. The guy has never given up. But I'm sorry, Andre, but this time I'm gonna favor Chase Sherman. I think Chase Sherman wins this one.